During the 1995-96 season, Nebraska celebrated its 100th year of college basketball. And the Huskers made the season something special by celebrating the school's first ever national tournament title. The season began with a lot of promise. NU returned four starters off the previous year's squad. Guards Eric Strickland and Jerron Boone. Forward Terrence Badgett and center Mikey Moore. Added to the mix were seniors Tom Wall, Chris Salee, and Jason Glock, along with newcomers Teron Liu, Bernard Garner, and Vincent Hamilton. Danny Nee's 10th team had a roster full of youth and experience, and plenty of talent top to bottom. The Huskers had the opportunity to showcase it all right out of the gate. The team tipped off the 100th season of Nebraska basketball in style by winning the Big Island Invitational in Hawaii. Eric Strickland was named to the All-Tournament team, while Jerron Boone was named the tournament's most valuable player and Big 8 player of the week as the Big Red Crews passed Toledo, Oregon, and Minnesota en route to the Big Island title. Back in Lincoln to open the home schedule, NU added the Emeritus Classic Tournament title to its list of accomplishments as the Big Red opened the season by winning its first six games. Boone was again named the MVP and was joined by Eric Strickland on the All-Tournament team. The Huskers were blending the old with the new. Newcomers Teron Liu and Bernard Garner had already worked their way into the starting lineup. And for Garner, the 1995 National Junior College Player of the Year, the transition to big-time college basketball was smooth and fun.
I had to get used to the competition. Playing against much stronger guys, faster guys than I did at the JUCO level. And I adapted to it pretty well. It was great. At first, you know, I was kind of nervous and stuff because I never played in front of 13 to 14,000 people and plus being on TV. It was just a great experience for me.
It was also clear that this was one of the strongest freshman classes in Nebraska basketball history. Liu was dazzling at the point guard position, while fellow freshman Vincent Hamilton and Andy Markowski came off the bench to give the Huskers excellent depth.
You know, I grew up watching Nebraska athletics, and it was just fun to get out and play in front of 13,000 people and, you know, travel to all the Big 8 arenas and, you know, feel Allen Fieldhouse at Kansas and, you know, get a feeling of college athletics.
The Huskers continued to show their championship potential in the Far West Classic Tournament. In the first round, NU beat the host school, Oregon, 99-76. In that win, Boone scorched the Nets for 25 points, while Garner and Mikey Moore chipped in 16 and 15, respectively. In the championship game, NU dropped a close 69-66 decision to Mississippi State. But considering that the Bulldogs went on to the NCAA Final Four, the Huskers were showing that they could indeed play with the nation's best. Nebraska closed out the non-conference portion of the season with impressive wins against nationally ranked Texas and Long Beach State. The Huskers' non-conference record was 13-3, and a big reason for the team's early success was the steady and solid play off the bench of seniors Tom Wall and Terrence Badgett.
Tom Wall and Terrence Badgett, they've come off the bench and just saved us. I mean, they've come off the bench and been stepped in just like starters would, stepped in and contributed and been difference makers. Wall's especially valuable at the end of the game with free throw shooting, and I feel Terrence Badgett is like the emotion leader.
I've grown to love and respect and care about Nebraska basketball as well as the teammates and the staff. So it's just wonderful just to be able to experience what I've experienced, because that's how it is, family.
As the final season of Big 8 play got underway, the Huskers were on a roll. And NU kept right on rolling by winning three of its first four conference games. The only setback in that stretch came at Oklahoma in a game which came to typify the rest of the conference season. The Huskers played hard and had multiple opportunities to bring home an elusive Big 8 road win. NU had the ball with a chance to win at the end of regulation, and also at the end of the first two overtimes. In fact, with time running out at the end of the first OT, Boone made this miraculous shot, and the Huskers celebrated an apparent victory. But while they celebrated, the officials met and then ruled that because the shot went over the back of the backboard, the basket was no good. Nebraska eventually lost the game in triple overtime. Still, the Huskers bounced back with impressive wins at Oklahoma State and at home against Missouri. That set up a nationally televised battle for the top spot in the Big 8 between Nebraska and Kansas. The Devaney Center crowd of over 14,000 was rocking as NU and KU went toe-to-toe for the first 20 minutes. Strickland and Garner were pacing the Huskers as NU led throughout much of the first half. Kansas, however, hit a late bucket to take a one-point lead into the locker room. In the second half, the Jayhawks, ranked number 3 in the country, pulled away for the win. The rest of the Big 8 season turned out to be a struggle for the Huskers. NU was in nearly every game, but the team was having trouble finding a way to win.
It was just a matter of not getting, you know, a couple calls here and there and the ball bouncing the wrong way, and it just, you know, it was kind of like an avalanche. It's just a snowball effect.
When the final Big 8 tournament rolled around, the players knew they needed to win the title in order to make it into the NCAA tournament. Nebraska played its heart out, but ended up losing the game 62-60. In a highly competitive Big 8 tournament, the Huskers provided the toughest test for the eventual champion Cyclones. The 100th season of Nebraska basketball, however, was not yet over. Far from it. The Huskers would earn a school record 6th straight invitation to a postseason tournament, one of the nation's longest streaks.
Our seniors are special. You know, the Boone, Strickland, Badgett, Wall, Jason Glock, and Chris Sally, these guys have their medal. I mean, there's a tough side of them, and I think we're going to prove all our critics wrong.
Nebraska received an invitation to play in college basketball's oldest national tournament, the NIT. And despite a season of highs and lows, the players were determined to go out champions.
We didn't want the seniors to go out with a sad season, so we had to turn something around at some point in time and to, you know, let them go out happy as seniors or with some type of a championship.
Tom Wall came up before the game started. He was like, let's go ahead and win it. And he was like, yeah, come on, let's go ahead and win the game. He's like, no, let's go ahead and win it all. Let's do it. Eric Strickland jumped up, was like, yeah, let's do it, let's win it all. Teron Lue got fired up. And Vincent Hamilton, who doesn't say too much, he got fired up, and you could just see the adrenaline in the room. And then Coach Knee got into it, and the coaching staff, and Jerron got into it. I knew something was about to happen.
The Huskers opened NIT play with a tough road game at Colorado State. After trailing throughout much of the first half, Nebraska was sizzling in the game's final 20 minutes, as the Big Red came from behind to beat Colorado State 91-83. 7 Huskers scored in double figures with Strickland's 19 points leading the way.
We knew they ran a lot of zone and, like, you know, a lot of, you know, they ran triangle and two on Strick and Gerard, which left me open for the three. So I feel pretty confident shooting tonight.
It feels good, you know, winning a postseason game. You know, it's always fun, no matter if it's NIT or NCAA. Now we just have to, you know, go back to practice and get ready for Washington State or Gonzaga and wherever we play at. We can't die down right now because, you know, if we can win the NIT tournament, it'll be good for the younger guys next year.
In the second round of the NIT, the Huskers welcomed Washington State to the Devaney Center. The final home game of the 96 campaign turned into showtime as the players put their considerable talents on display in front of an enthusiastic crowd. The Huskers shot a blistering 59% en route to a convincing 82-73 win. After the game, Washington State coach Kevin Eastman said Nebraska was the second best team his Cougars had played all season, ahead of perennial powers UCLA and Syracuse.
After we went up to Colorado State and won, you know, you could see the team getting confidence, and we had a home game the second game, and we were all excited about that, and we won. You know, we were just excited about playing and doing things. Everybody was playing relaxed and with confidence, and it was amazing what we'd done when we played with confidence.
Next up, Nebraska faced the most difficult assignment of the tournament, playing at Fresno State. Jerry Tarkanian's club came into the game having won 15 straight at home, and the Bulldogs opened up an early 13-point lead. But the Huskers hung tough and dominated the second half of play to pull off a big upset, 82-73, and advance to the semifinals of the NIT in New York City.
It's a beautiful place to play. Hope to be here next year.
Just remembering the feel of the Garden, being at the Madison Square Garden my senior year, is something I've never expected. And just the joy we had and to see those fans that were there supporting us. And I think that's what I'm gonna remember the most, is looking into those eyes and how proud they were of us and how proud each other we were of each other.
Nebraska's opponent in the NIT semifinals was Tulane, and Brooklyn native Danny Nee had his Huskers thinking positive prior to tip-off.
Tulane is a good basketball team, but I don't care if they were the Knicks coming out there tonight. It doesn't matter. It's going to be a hard-fought game, but it's a winnable game. Now, all I'm asking you to do is go out and give yourselves that shot. Get focused now. Go out and warm up. It is Madison Square Garden. It is special. It is good. It's all of that. But now we play 40 minutes of Nebraska basketball, and you play it the best way you can. And you're helping yourself, you're helping the team, and you're doing what's right.
If the Huskers were nervous about playing at Madison Square Garden, they didn't show it. In fact, Mikey Moore, Terrence Badgett, and Eric Strickland were putting on displays that would have made the Knicks proud. As a result, the favored Green Wave was simply no match for the Huskers. NU won the semifinal game easily, 90-78. Strickland and Bernard Garner each scored 20 points, while Vincent Hamilton had 13 points and 9 rebounds. Nebraska advanced to the NIT Championship game for the first time in school history, and the Huskers were also hoping to become the first Big 8 team to win the NIT in 56 years.
Good, we're gonna win it tomorrow.
Just real quick. Look, great job. I mean, you really did it. You did it as a team, you did it with the defense. You just play. Hey, we didn't play a perfect game, and we're not gonna play a perfect game, but we just gotta keep handling it. Okay?
Yeah.
Two nights later, Nebraska met St. Joseph's for the NIT title. The Philadelphia school had the home court advantage on its side, while the Huskers had destiny on theirs.
We already claimed the NIT championship that night after Tulane. We knew it. We knew it because we came that far, and there's no way we're going to let St. Joe's beat us in the championship game. There's no way.
Gentlemen, it's a piece of history. Now, I understand you don't understand it now, but you know, you're young, but 100 years of basketball, 100 years we played, and they've never won a modern-day national-type championship. Tonight, we're going to make that step, and it's going to belong to you. It's not going to be done on the sideline. It's going to be done between the lines with blood, sweat, and tears. Get out there, get after them, give them nothing. Don't talk to them. Don't smile. You stay focused. When it says 0-0-0, that's when we're going to celebrate. That's when we're going to cut down the nets.
Nebraska fell behind by 5 points, 18-13, midway through the first half. But it was then that the Huskers went to work. Jerron Boone ignited the attack with a pair of long-range three-pointers. And then Eric Strickland got the Huskers' patented fast-break offense moving in high gear. Terrence Badgett put down a powerful dunk as time ran out to give Nebraska a 34-26 halftime lead over St. Joseph. In the second half, NU quickly increased its lead to as many as 13 points. Mikey Moore, Vincent Hamilton, and Bernard Garner were taking over on the inside.
Garner, high post, shot clock at 6. Oh, a kiss off the glass.
I'll say, rewarded.
While Teron Liu was dazzling the New York City crowd with his spectacular play.
Nice drive by Liu. Oh, is that pretty?
The coaches will be dealing with that drivability for the next 3 years in the Big 12.
As the final seconds ticked off, the Nebraska basketball team earned its final reward of the season, the championship in the National Invitation Tournament.
Nebraska is the NIT champion with five consecutive wins.
Strickland and company superior.
And Nebraska ruins the Cinderella dream of St. Joseph's. 60-56, they are the champions.
Did it, baby.
Following the game, the Huskers savored every minute of their celebration at the Madison Square Garden. This was a team that had battled back from adversity to prove that they were in champion.
It's a real great feeling. You know, something we worked hard for all year. You know, I know we had a roller coaster season, but you know, once we pieced it together, it just started coming back. And once we got here, we knew we could win it.
I mean, it feels great to come in, you know, as a freshman and make the all-tournament team. I thought I came in and played pretty well, and the team played good. We played well. I know a lot of people think we can do it, but we did it, and we're the NIT champions.
We finally feel like we came together and got the monkey off our back and proved to everybody that we can play ball with the best.
Holding his head perhaps the highest was senior guard Eric Strickland. For his outstanding leadership and all-out play, Eric was rewarded by being named the NIT Most Valuable Player.
Well, it meant a great deal for me. I'm thankful to my teammates, especially for sticking by me and to sticking together to accomplish something that no other Nebraska team has ever done, and that was to win any kind of national championship. And it makes me feel proud and happy that, especially for my teammates, who stepped up in the end and made my season and the senior season more gratifying.
Gratifying indeed. Nebraska coach Danny Nee and assistants Jimmy Williams, Scott Howard, and Bill Johnson rallied this team. And together they accomplished something that no Nebraska team before it had ever done. And now as they begin the second 100 years of Nebraska basketball, the Huskers are looking to the success of 96 as the foundation for the program's future. But before moving on, the team bids farewell to a senior class that together helped NU win not only the NIT championship, but was also part of the team's first ever Big 8 Tournament Championship back in 1994. Eric Strickland, Jerron Boone, Terrence Badgett, Tom Wall, Jason Glock, and Chris Salee will all be missed.
I wish you all the best of luck, and I just want to say that yeah, I loved you guys, and I loved playing with you, and thanks a lot.
I love all you guys, and don't forget about what we accomplished. Don't forget what we overcame. Not for one moment. Hold on to your prayers and your faith, and you can accomplish anything. Never give up on yourself. And never give up on your teammates.